I don't believe in political correctness, because Frederick Forsyth, sometime back, very famously say, political correctness is the new kind of fascism staring in this world. When in the country, half of the celebrities whom we see on page 3 are celebrating the fact that their Twitter images of how fit they are have been bandied about in the social media. It's great to see in Guwahati, due to the initiative of Gautam Khan and other people who are associated with him, Biswajit Gogoi and all, two very respected, honorable persons associated with this field have come here and have discussed all those issues threadbare, I believe, in last 2 days, in a way in which I entered the deafening silence. It became so profoundly terrifying for me, not because of what I have seen as a layman, but because of the fact that in this part of the country, because of your presence and because of their initiative, what a beautiful blending of that particular emotion when the world is busy in dishing out something else. We are doing something. It's not symbolic, but substantive. I think hats off to you, and I want you to, as a sense of Assamese hospitality, a great sense of appreciation to Professor Commissioner and all other guests, Roy Choudhury and others who have come all the way, and try to amplify, underline and underscore few points which are very, very important if you want to develop as a sinner human being in this civilizational critical moments staring all throughout the world, and more so in the country now. I don't want to go into any politics, don't be scared of that. But if I come back to the customary part, respected Professor Kameshwaram, Professor Roy Choudhury, I hope I have pronounced your name correctly, because the Assamese pronunciation tends to get haywire at times, especially when, but our love and appreciation from anyone who loves us doesn't go haywire at any point of time. So maybe after 25 years or 50 years also, with these people we will be inviting you as earnestly and as happily as they have done now. Professor Roy Choudhury, I think Gautam Khan's friend that he has already mentioned, and that initiative, the soldiers, under the able stewardship of Dr. Gautam Khan, I remember Biswajit Gogoi, who came to invite me and tried to teach me many things about ENT doctors, how this cochlear implant and all other things go about. And he could not, and he was so animated. He was a very good teacher, like the wonderful teacher of Gautam Khan. He thought, this man, he's a faculty member. Actually, I'm not a bureaucrat, I'm a faculty member. And that's identity is not very important, because of the fact as an informal student of human behavior. And whatever little studies I have done during the course of my works, which is not related to my job, he thought that this man will be able to appreciate, and later on when he comes, he will be able to amplify or underscore few of the points to the benefit of the audience. I'm sorry, Biswajit, I'll not be able to. I could not understand. I pretended well that I understood you, but actually I did not understand anything, because that's not my cup of tea. And I'm stressing that. Why? It's not my cup of tea, but as we came to know, all good things in life, as you have rightly mentioned, it developed due to a passion. It might have developed over a cup of tea. I don't have any double or hidden meaning. I think when Gautam Khan speaks, it's tea means tea only. So it cannot be anything else. That's the reputation of Gautam Khan, because I have met him after 15 years. All those years I have not met him physically, but always I admired this man. I went to him, I think 15, 16 years back as a patient. And the kind of hearing, I always like to say, when you ENT doctors, I have a feeling, I am a layman, so I can say anything and I can be excused, I know, because you are all good people, magnanimous people. I think ENT doctors have got a terrific sense of balance, because you deal with ear and nose, and both are more or less equidistant from your brain and heart. So I think you can strike that balance very, very beautifully, and you, with lot of style and panels, you cover your, you accomplish your jobs. Now the important point is, what does the society want from the doctors? I think that's one point. At the time when Pratidhwani has been inaugurated by you, I think these are some issues the society at large, because mostly here we have got doctors or the people who are associated with the medical field. But ultimately, if you plumb into human sentiments, you will find our critical moments, our crisis, our fear, our anxiety, many things it can be addressed by a doctor, provided that doctor is willing to give a helping hand as well as lend an ear to the demands, to the pestering things that the patients very often disturb you. But I think the time has changed, and now good to see like people like Gautam Khan, and you are only a robust template. Don't take all the whatever appreciation I have been making only for you. You have to dissipate, you have to distribute among all, since you are very too handsome to miss, and he's sitting straight in front of me, knowing fully well that I have to be in front of him because he can be politically incorrect. So that way also a good doctor can do what he has been doing now. So a good doctor cannot be only doctor who is good at his instruments. Frankly, believe me, when I came, it was profoundly terrifying for me entering you. You are talking in a very, very somber and beautiful academic. The academic overtones and scholastic underpinnings of your lecture, I could not understand. You can know it very well. But the way all the people have heard you in rapt attention, that is a testimony to the fact how these people are passionate about, excited about the whole issue of cochlear implant, if I have pronounced the word correctly. Biswa can correct me because he's my teacher as far as my ENT scholarship goes. Okay, because nobody dared to teach me. He only came to me, to my institute, and tried to teach me a few things. So, you are very right. I think Henry Ford said very famously, a business that makes or thinks about making only money is a very poor kind of business. And what Gautam Khan, on a serious note, I am telling you, and your team, what you have been trying to do because of your passion, I think is not a business to make money. It is a business to make people happy and perhaps a rendering a service against some reasonable payment. I don't know what will be the modalities, but I feel there is no free lunch, no free dinner in this world. If somebody is getting a subsidized treatment, somebody else is paying for it. But I am sure what Professor Kamesham, on this auspicious occasion, what he has said, I would like to paraphrase it in a different way. When we are thinking only about our salaries, like our old not the mobile numbers, like our landline numbers, perhaps we are happier. Now all of us, or not all of us, some of us, we try to aspire our income or bank balance to be like our mobile number, 10 digits. And we really chase after, hanker after those zeros in bank balances or in our bank accounts. And in the process, we become some sort of machines. And don't take the blame all. I'm not blaming all. There would be some black sheep in all the profession, including in my profession. What you are trying to do today, what you are trying to say to the society today, by holding a candle aloft to the fact that despite being successful doctors, we can do something for the society, because you know very well what is the demand of the society, where the society is suffering, in which area, you can all come forward so that some broad smiles can be ensured on the face of the disadvantaged section of the people, the have-nots of your society. I think Pratidhwani, the name for an Assamese, is very, very, we can be very nostalgic thinking about Bhupen Hazarika's Pratidhwani Hunu, when during the 1962 Chinese aggression time, he beautifully painted this number and also rendered his mellifluous voice to it. So Pratidhwani is a reverberation. I think it's a, some sort of resonation that we want to be felt in society under your stewardship. And I think for that, I don't know any government people, Thakuria Damoria, he is there. He's from the recruitment board. I'm sure to the government also, he will try to establish a connect between whatever facilities being given. I think Dr. Sharma Madam also told me in GMC, you have got some facilities about cochlear implant. If this facility can be done in a private-public partnership mode, and if people like Pratidhwani, the people who are manning this Pratidhwani, also a woman, I think Pragya, if these people can establish a robust bridge between what government is doing, what the society is expecting, and what a private hospital is doing, I think you can do a yeoman service to the society. I think that's the need of the hour. That's the need of the hour. I'm very sure that the passion with which you have come, you will definitely try to translate all those things into reality. I had a feeling when I came that I will try to quote. Now only I'm looking onto the page, because I got so mesmerized by your lecture, I thought I should not look at this, because this is a dry piece of paper. I think these things are important. I thought I'll quote Einstein just to terrify some of the people, not all, that this man also knows, he can also quote Einstein and say, I was telling about balance. Einstein said very famously, if you want to keep balance in life, you have to keep moving. And the simile he used was that of a bicycle. And another very famous thinker, scholar, and ex-British Prime Minister, one of my favorites, Benjamin Disraeli, who very famously said and became extremely unpopular with the statisticians of the world that there are three kind of lies, lies, damn lies and statistics. Disraeli said famously one thing, what I feel would have been very, very appropriate for me, having come here, having agreed to come here. Disraeli said if you are conscious about the fact that you are ignorant, that itself is a great step towards knowledge. I came here not because of your teaching, Biswajit, only because of what Disraeli taught me 20 years back during my Delhi University days. That is because of the fact I know Biswajit will be damn angry with me. I don't know whether my dinner is ensured or not and whatever else. But don't get angry. I pretended, well, you should be happy about the fact that you can also, if you can have a drama in 25 years celebration, we can all act and have some jolly moments around when this Pratidhwani will be completing some milestone in the times to come. Another important fact I would like to say, the first condition of immortality, many people, it's a googly kind of a question in quiz, but a famous poet from Poland, his name is Stanisław Lech, he said that first condition of immortality is death. If we do not die, you cannot think of becoming immortal. Similarly, about the medical profession, let me be very honest and serious here. When I say serious, I am a layman, as an informal student of human behavior. Let me say this, we have got a lot of misconception about the medical doctors fraternity as such. Why? Because of, you know that very well. You don't want me to explain on this occasion what are the reasons for that. Because you are not cause of that particular phenomenon. You are a remedy. The fact that you have come with Pratidhwani is a remedy towards demolishing that particular myth or not myth, I will not say quote-unquote myth. I think this is a initiative for dismantling that state of mind in some of the people's mind. Why some people feel that today's few of the doctors are not having a mindset that we are doing a service, rendering a service against payment. Don't get me wrong. The very senior doctors are there. Tomorrow I fall sick, try to get an appointment, they will refuse me. So, but even then, at the risk of that, I will tell, kindly, I think it's really go away, because this is one profession. See, people say about police, people say about advocates and lawyers, they don't want to go because nobody wants to be in trouble and go into a police case or trouble. But doctors, they do not say that. Doctors, it's not a fun thing to go to a doctor. It's a fun thing to come here and give some lectures and get some brownie points. But it's not good to go to a doctor when you fall sick. But we cannot avoid that. We can avoid getting into some sort of embroil and not going into police and advocates, but doctors, we all know we have to go. So that relationship is an organic kind of relationship. You also in turn have to go to a surgeon or maybe to any other discipline. So I think that that linkage needs to be made more robust and more friendly. It can be, there can be some exchange of money and all, I don't mind that. There has to be, as I told in the beginning, there will be no freelance and dinner in this world. Somebody has to pay for it. And in a time when the pro-market economy is dictating the whole contours of economic and political system in the country, not only in India, all throughout the world, this is going to be the deciding factor. There is no point raising our voice against that. But even at the risk of sounding very, very cliched or hackneyed, I will say that I think that breeze needs to be, that connection needs to be made more, much stronger and more robust in the times to come. I think Pratidhwani is in that particular direction, it will go. And soft skill, since I'm associated with teaching soft skill to people who come from India and other parts of the world in my institute, I think soft skill of doctors are very, very important. I'm very sure if not anyone else you will endorse, because just now you have been mentioning about counseling. Importance of counseling, what I understood when you answered this gentleman beautifully, that if you do not counsel, then I think many people, many parents will think that my son or daughter will rise and maybe he or she will become like Ramdev. You are mentioning about Gita, he or she will become Ramdev, dishing out all kind of pontification on the television screen. But if you counsel him properly, lending an ear to silence, what Mayur Bora telling other audience and other people is actually a luxury. If you try to imagine yourself in the shoes of those parents whose son and daughter are having this difficulty. So we cannot give that luxury. It will sound very patronizing. It will sound disturbingly patronizing. It is not proper to do like this. So I think lending an ear to silence is a luxury which only the normal human beings can afford. For people who are not in that, do not have that luxury, who have got that problem, I think we have to hear to their problem, listen to their problems, and try to come up with a solution. I think Pratidhwani has come only to solve those solutions. Pratidhwani will be able to solve. I'd like to tell you, I don't know what will be the modality of payments and all, but I'm very sure this will be one sort of a resounding example or a template for which many other people in Northeast will come and try to follow this model. I think for that challenge lies there, because you are the challenge for yourself. Just Obama and Gandhi also said that you should be the change. Like I think Gautam Khand and his team in the northeastern region on the other side of the chicken neck, I think they will be raising the bar of challenge for themselves, because there are no other players. And I think that doesn't mean that you can sit back and relax. Now you are sitting back, relaxing, occasionally smiling. Fine, you are increasing my confidence. Lot some of my butterflies have gone. But after this is over, once you get back to work, I think this will be the expectation, as you have called me and I told that I don't believe in political correctness. I think that's the expectation of, not my personal expectation, but expectation of the society. Having said that, I think I should come to an, I don't want to bore you with my lecture, but I would like to say one thing. I quoted one Polish poet, Stanislaw Lem, that first condition of immortality is death. But time has changed. Time has changed. We all appreciate. You order a pizza today and call the policeman, pizza will be faster on your table than the policeman. It was not so earlier. Time has changed, so we have to move with the changing face of time. No, it's true. You order any pizza and you call the policeman who is nearby. I can take the liberty of calling. I don't want to put into you in trouble. You see, pizza will be faster. This is the changing face of time. We must know how to, is it? But having said that, some of the fundamental qualities of a human being will always or should always remain same. It cannot change. There are certain aspects in society like sati, that child marriage, then polygamy and all have over a period of time have gone. Because people thought, the new people thought that it's not the right thing to do. But some of the certain aspects of life, the respect towards elders, respect towards integrity, honesty, respect to be punctual, all those things have remained from time immemorial. If you want to do well as a human being and also as a good professional, any profession, it may be doctor, architect or anyone. So I think those things will remain, and I should not say much about that, should not counsel or advise you. At the end, I'd like to say one thing. I would also like to quote another poet and also a trained physician from the same country, that is Poland. And his initial name is also same. He is Stanislaw Lem. The first one, the poet is Lem. He is a philosopher and a trained physician. He said, and this I want actually from on a serious note, on a lighter note, on all the notes if I can combine, I would like to give this appeal to Gautam Khand and his beautiful, wonderful team. He said, I don't trust people. Similarly, I would also like to say, you may be surprised why, I don't trust these people. Why? Because you are all capable of greatness. Be great. Try to pervade and permeate the atmosphere, the environment with your greatness, so that all the people in the society who have this need for their children, for their themselves, will come to you and you will extend your helping hand, and your helping hand will nothing but a small template of your greatness that will beautify their life. Thank you.
Thank you.